Here we are, guys, just like old times.
Remember when we used to do this back in the day?
Oh yeah.
Everyone is well and healthy.
Yes, yes.
Yeah. Yep. I'm a little lonely, I gotta be honest. I got stuck alone here. I'm like, I forget how to talk to other people.
Don't know how to start, but welcome all to our pirate radio show podcast thing. Five guys talking about things they know nothing about. We have dreamed of this show for many years, and here we are, finally. Fellas.
Howdy.
Hello.
We're living in some strange times, man. Some strange times.
You're painting and morphing into your head.
Exactly. Yeah, man.
So what do you guys want to talk about?
The rise and fall of humanity.
What's that?
The rise and fall of humanity.
Oh, no, I thought you said human centipede.
Yeah.
Next video idea. The five of us. I call the front.
Oh, shit. I call the back, dudes.
Shotgun.
I never saw that movie.
So I only came up with one question.
Fire
Not
away.
A good one. Albert, I was going to ask you, I was thinking about when you did the car interview thing.
Yes.
Whatever happened to that?
I burned the footage, don't you worry.
Did that come out?
I think last I remember I asked, you know, Jason had the hard drives and he can't find them. All I have
Wait,
is
Albert, fill us in. What is the car interview thing?
You're the only one who didn't do it. Right. It's, and I interviewed everyone in my car. Pretty straightforward.
Right. I remember.
It was, and by the way, may I add that this was pre comedian in cars getting coffee. And this was pre,
that carpool karaoke.
Carpool karaoke. Albert
the trailer. I have the trailer. Had you prepared me, I would have tried to find it. But the trailer was awesome. The theme song was 50-50 from Come Down Machine. And it just starts with like the riff. And it just like, it's all this outside footage of the car driving around. And then us, it looks really cool.
Yeah, I don't know that one. Just kidding. Have we ever played that live?
No. I'd like to play it live.
We should. Let's do it.
I'll only play it live if we call it Fitty Fitty.
Is that, that's not 50-50, is it?
No, that's chances.
But Albert, you can
play the wrong song. Which one is 50-50? How does that one go?
He doesn't know it either.
Albert, can't you play it? Albert, can't you play it on Wi-Fi there?
Oh man, I'll do better than that. Sorry, that was.
Yeah.
Oh shit.
Yeah, I remember this. This is great.
Now we should start this thing off. Starring Nikolai Fraser.
That's kind of how it. I just asked Jason if he could find it. Actually, maybe Ryan could ask the guy.
It sounds like a Monster Energy drink sponsored by like a high octane, like a monster truck show. So I had another question, actually. Anyone here read "Meet Me in the Bathroom"?
I thought that was a song.
Well, they turned the song into a novel.
That is ridiculous.
No, I'm kidding. No, it's that like Please Kill Me-esque book?
That's what I would ask if you asked me to read Meet Me in the Bathroom.
What?
I would say, please kill me.
Oh, shit.
Oh, wow.
Bill Withers just passed away, and he's one of the greatest ever. I thought maybe we could start by watching. You ever see him do... I think he did it. I think it was Soul Train, Lean on Me. You ever see that live thing of him? Anyway.
No, but I would love to.
Can we put it on now, though, for real, just to see it? Or you want to?
Sure. Here's, I don't know. Here it is. Yeah, no, let me find the link and I'll send it to them. Man, it's so fucked up. It's like, it's so hard to find shit now on YouTube. I don't know if you ever listen to albums on YouTube, but you can't listen to albums anymore. Like, you have to kind of listen to like individual songs, and then it kind of like forces you to listen to ads between each song. No,
that sucks.
There's a 1972 where he's introduced by Kenny Rogers. It's kind of cool.
Also, just died.
Just pile on the bummers.
Some records are so distinctive that you recognize them at the very few first notes. And anything this young man writes or sings is that way. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Bill Withers. Yeah.
Did you guys watch the one that I sent, or has the time passed?
No.
Bill Withers thing, though, man. It's just such a bummer. I don't know if it's like, it was a year. Maybe it's because Soul Train wanted like their YouTube views, because it's all like Soul Train hashtag things that they put up a year ago. But the one I wanted to play, it was like he does this like speech and he talks, and I can't find his damn speech. But whatever, they took it off.
Bill Withers gives a famous speech.
Well, he talks. It's just like, it's honestly the best part is the people singing along, and you catch just the beginning of him saying, y'all can sing if you like. I'm defeated. Technology and YouTube have defeated me.
Has it?
Henry. I'm singing.
So cool.
We all need somebody to lean on. I just might have a problem that you'll understand. We all need somebody to lean on. If there is a load you have to bear that you can't carry, I'm right up the road. I'll share your load. If you just call me, say, call me. Ever need a friend?
Cool, I thought.
Yeah, that was, it's beautiful. May he rest in peace.
Amen. Such an interesting career too. He was so big, he was so huge, and oh fuck. Well, caught it. was so huge, and then he just kind of, I don't know if he retired or like fell off the map or just quit music and just kind of lived a normal life, I think. I don't know.
He didn't make his first, he made his first record when he was 33.
Yeah, it's so cool. And the cover of his first record, he's got like a lunchbox because he was working at the airport and he took, they did the photo shoot during his lunch break.
Wow, that's amazing.
Strokes come out with completely tone deaf Zoom chat.
Just be the Strokes come out.
No, it's
alienate all their fans.
It'll be a great. It'll be like the Strokes come out with. No, the Strokes are tone deaf, and not just with their music. Be an easy bad review.
That's what Jan Wenner, the Rolling Stone guy, told me. The owner of Rolling Stone.
What did he say?
Told me I was tone deaf.
Are you serious?
What? Yeah. In what regard?
Don't feel bad, man. He slapped my face. He literally slapped me in the face.
Don't feel bad.
What?
Yeah,
what
remember
the
I
fuck?
We had that meeting and I was like hung over and I got there late and you guys were all in his office and I got there just in the last 3 minutes and then everybody got up and I was like, "Oh man, I'm so sorry." And he was like, "Pop!" And he hit me across my face.
I don't remember that at all.
I don't remember that either.
I think he was trying to do like a tuck, tuck, tuck. Like, it's okay, kid. But it was like, just like ever so.
He didn't want to like knee jerk, like, don't touch me, dad.
Yeah, kind of.
But what did he
mean? But wait, Jules, he told you you were tone deaf, like, in what regard?
I told him, I can't remember why, but. I had a hole in my eardrum and I was like, oh yeah, I have a hole in my eardrum, or I don't know if I still do, but whatever I had from like ear infection.
Tubes?
Popping. You get an ear infection so bad it like bursts. Pretty painful. But I was telling him that and he's like, oh, so you're tone deaf. And I was like, excuse me, say what? A sphincter says what? And I was like, I couldn't tell if he was like fucking with me.
Do you think that he was just trying to make a joke?
I think he was saying if you have a hole in your eardrum, you're tone deaf technically. And I was like thinking, that's such a rude thing to say, but I didn't know.
Now get over here. I want to put you on the cover of my magazine.
Was that pre that?
In
a movie, it would be the same day. He would, like, say it to you and be like, now go take that photo.
You tone-deaf motherfucker.
Para bailar la bamba. Para bailar la bamba.
I think it's impossible to sync up. I wish we could play together this way, but... there's no way to sync it up.
Practicing would be so easy and cost effective.
pick a song and we could get started.
Good Vibrations, Marky Mark and the Funky Bunch.
Mm-hmm. You going this way and then went this.
We could do his cover of Walk on the Wild Side.
Do you guys remember when we played Walk on the Wild Side with Lou Reed?
Oh, yeah. I can't believe we don't have good footage of that.
Idiots. We should have like three cameras.
Yeah.
That was funny enough for the Rolling Stone party.
Oh, yeah, and it's not like we didn't know. We rehearsed with him.
Yeah, and then Eddie Vedder came out and played too.
Anything for Jan Wenner.
Anything.
Well, thanks for watching our first episode. We will be back with a preview of the album next time. Thank you for watching.
A review.
Be safe, everyone.
Bye! Oh, no shoes!
So no pants either, I'm at home.